Hello and welcome. I'm your host KB, and you're watching the Retrospective.
One, two, three, and four.
If you were a kid in the 90s and 2000s and had a TV, then Nickelodeon was likely a big part of your childhood. To this day, the brand is iconic and continues to pump out classic TV shows year after year.
You're never done doing Nickelodeon.
While I personally was always more of an animation fan as a kid, and Nickelodeon had a plethora of original series to keep me entertained, they also had an amazing lineup of game shows as well as live action series. Shows like Are You Afraid of the Dark?, Clarissa Explains It All, and The Adventures of Pete and Pete were all well received by kids and are still very much beloved today. Another big hit for the company was the show All That, which was a sketch show starring kids. The show first aired in 1994, and since then has seen two series revivals, with a total of 11 seasons released to date, which is a mammoth effort. The show would launch the careers of several young actors, such as Nick Cannon and Amanda Bynes, both of whom would go on to star in their own Nickelodeon-produced series. All That would also go on to launch the careers as well as unite the duo of Kenan Thompson and Kel Mitchell. While working together, the duo would prove to have great chemistry, leading them to star alongside each other in a couple of different projects, including the 1997 film Good Burger, and also in their own series, The Kenan and Kel Show, which first aired on Nickelodeon in 1996. While using their first names, the actors played fictional characters, with Kenan playing Kenan Rockmore and Kel as Kel Kimball. With Kenan playing the quick-witted schemer and Kel as the lovable orange soda-obsessed goofball, the episodes would mainly take place in the Rockmore household and Kenan's workplace, a grocery store named Rigby's. The plots would see the duo dealing with typical teenage dilemmas from schooling to girls, and would often find themselves getting into and trying to get themselves out of trouble.
Well, looks like I'm gonna have to shut down your club.
Why?
Because this building's only supposed to have 15 people in it at once. Looks like you got far more than 15 here.
What's this?
A fine for $300.
All right, everybody move!
Okay, come on, Kale, Kyra. All right, back here.
Hayden, come back! Hayden, wait!
Besides its stars, we also have actors such as Dan Frischman as Rigby's store owner Chris Potter, and Kevin Forey, better known for his horror movie roles, playing Kenan's dad, the combustible Roger Rockmore.
What happened?
I want to know who's responsible. Who's responsible?
I'll see y'all later. Pop! Pop, please, he's got his whole life ahead of him.
I'm just a child.
Okay, here, let me shine your head while you eat.
Stop that!
There you go, right there.
Away, go, leave, and never come back here again.
But father,
don't but father me. That boy is nothing but trouble.
a pimple on the face that is my life!
The casting is solid all around, but Kenan and Kel are definitely the breakout stars here. Sure, the stories were quite goofy, with obnoxious catchphrases aplenty, but there was also a lot of genuinely funny dialogue with good slapstick humor to be found here.
Come on, Kenan.
I almost got it.
Shit!
Okay, hold on.
Come on.
Hold on.
Let me help you.
Wait.
Featuring colourful characters and equally colourful sets, the show is the typical Orange Douse Nickelodeon production and definitely makes for a fun watch. An interesting aspect of the show, at least to me, was the opening and closing segments, which would see our stars in the studio introducing themselves and the episode to a live studio audience, effectively breaking the fourth wall in what is otherwise a straight-up sitcom.
Come on, Kel. You and I got some business to take care of. Come back! Let me tell you more about the fat baby. The fat baby movie. The obese baby. Kenan? Here it goes.
The show also featured a super cool theme song, pun intended, written and performed by the 90s rap legend himself, Coolio.
Everybody out there, go run and tell your homeboys and homegirls it's time for Kenan and Kel. To keep you laughing in the afternoon, so don't touch that dial on read the room. Cause they always in the summer no frontin' and you don't wanna miss it. It's double K like do the good players.
I personally loved the show as a kid, and while I didn't notice it at the time, the series was quite groundbreaking for having two African-American teenagers as the stars of a live-action children's series. The show would go on to have a solid run as it lasted for 4 seasons, with a total of 65 episodes being produced between 1996 and 1999. Most of the episodes have been released on physical media, with there being a couple of best of DVD releases produced, but unfortunately the complete series is only available to be watched online via streaming services.
Have you noticed anything strange about him lately? Who loves orange soda? Kel loves orange soda. Is it true? Is it true? Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, it's true. Ooh. I do. Ooh.
Nope, no stranger than usual.
Aside from the Kenan and Kel series, both actors would go on to have steady careers. Kel's most high-profile role being in the 1999 film Mystery Men, while Kenan has had a solid 17-year run on Saturday Night Live. The duo would reunite a couple more times, notably in 2015 for a Good Burger sketch on The Tonight Show, and again in 2018 for an All That-themed reunion on fellow All That alumni Nick Cannon's series, Wildin' Out. While I am a big fan of Kenan and Kel, I don't necessarily need to see a revival of the series, but I would love to see another type of reunion, much like the Good Burger reunion, whether they did it on The Tonight Show or Saturday Night Live.
This ain't the Hardy Boys or a Nancy Drew mystery. It's just Kenan and Kel in your vicinity. Like Siegfried and Roy, Abbott and Costello, Magic and Kareem, or Penn and Teller. Somebody's in trouble. Oh, here you go. Oh, Nick.
Once again, thank you very much for watching this episode. Please drop a comment, hit like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done already. And as always, I'll catch you guys on the next episode of The Retrospective.